Good morning. I'm Elliot Sadlon. I use he, him pronouns, and I'd like to welcome you to Bucksmont UU Fellowship's multi-platform worship, where moved by love, we share lifelong journeys of growth, wonder, and healing, nurturing wholeness in society and spirit, creating a community of justice and compassion. I'd like to give a welcome to everyone joining us online and in person today. Members, friends, and those who may be newcomers to our community this morning. As we begin our service, please take a moment to silence your cell phones. If you're new to Bucksmont and visiting us in person today, please stop by our visitor center in the front hallway near where you came in. There you can also make a name tag for yourself and find more information about Unitarian Universalism, Bucksmont Fellowship, and upcoming events. If you'd like a hymnal or a printed order of service, those are available near the entrance to the sanctuary. If you're visiting us online or prefer digital methods, please email our office administrator, Beverly, to sign up for our email newsletter and to get connected to our congregation. You may also follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Bucksmont UU. Each week in our service, we offer time for people to share a joy or sorrow from their lives by texting a phone number. That number is shared on screen for everyone now and will be again later in the service. If you'd like to see the order of service, details about upcoming services, and other ways to gather with our community, you can find that on the homepage of our website, bucksmontuu.org. There's a lot happening at Bucksmont, and we'd like to highlight these announcements in particular. Statements were emailed or mailed on August 6th. They show all donations made from July 23 through June 2024. Please check your spam if you think you did not receive your emailed statement. Any questions should be directed to David Marshall. Do you enjoy singing for fun? Do you like listening to other people sing and play musical instruments? Song Circle meets on the second Saturday of each month from 7 to 9 p.m. as a hybrid group, in person and on Zoom. Song Circle is a non-judgmental space where we gather because we like sharing and listening to many types of music. Folk, rock, jazz, you name it. You can sing or just come to listen. For more information, see Friday's eVoice or talk to Mary Utes or Harry Rothwell. Registration for religious education is now open. Please see the eVoice or our website for the form to sign your child up for classes this year. Additionally, RE is looking for teachers and volunteers for the classes that are being offered, which range in age from birth through teenagers. Melissa will make it as easy as possible for you, but please let her know that you're interested. Reading The Wheel of Time as Sacred Text with Rev Kev. Join our summer book club on August 28th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. To get the book and find out more, email Rev Kev or check the weekly e-newsletter. Whether you are a guest, friend, or member, we are glad you are part of our worship service today. Thank you.
As we gather in our sanctuary, in our homes, or watch from mobile screens almost anywhere, we are all together. Those watching now on Sunday and those who may be watching months from now, we are joined together for worship across both space and time. This is a free, creedless religious congregation in the discipline of truth and in the spirit of universal kinship. We join together in a cooperative quest for religious and ethical values, seeking to apply these values to the development of character, enrichment of the spirit, and service to all. You are welcome here. Whoever you are, whomever you love, whatever the color of your skin or your country of origin, no matter your gender expression or gender identity, whatever your age, however you define family, wherever you are at this moment, in this time, and whatever the source of your faith, you are welcome here.
This morning, as we do each time we gather, we kindle our Unitarian Universalist chalice. We do so today with words from Jean Wallstrom. In this small flame dwell, the beacon light of lanterns guiding travelers home, the warmth of hearth fires tended through the generations, the transforming energy of furnaces and the power and life of our sun. May these blessings, warmth and light and life-giving energy, be kindled in each of us. Please light your chalice at home. Our common chalice is now lit.
Good morning. My name's Lynn Nugent. I use she, her pronouns, and I'm going to be your hymn leader today. Please rise in body or spirit and join me in singing our first hymn, which is number 21, For the Beauty of the Earth. It's time for all ages, everyone. Come on up for the young and the young at heart.
My name is Melissa Sperringer. I'm the Director of Religious Education here, and I use she, her pronouns. We have a large group today, and I'm hoping the whole congregation can get involved today. So it is so good that we have so many young leaders up here. Are you guys ready to be helpful? Yeah? Okay. Who would like to open the Wonder Box? Leota, I think it's been a minute since you've done it, right? Yeah, why don't you open the Wonder Box today? Okay, you want to come over here? You have a lot of goodies today. Lift it, there you go. All right, and lift it, open it up. What's inside? A heart pillow and a heart, what's that? Rock. So are those, they're similar, right? But they're also kind of opposites, aren't they? How would you describe them? Correct, soft and hard. And there's a lot of opposites in our world, aren't there? Yes, that's a great one. So can we act out small, small, and big? Yeah. All right, what are some other opposites? Go ahead. Flowers are bigger than seeds. Trees are bigger than flowers. What about fast and slow? Can we do that one? Everyone can join us here. Fast and slow. Okay, what about, am I taller than you guys right now? Yeah, it's not often that that happens, right? So we have tall and short, right? What about, I'm on a microphone, so I'm pretty loud today, aren't I? Can we be loud? Ah! And what's the opposite of loud? What other opposites can we think of? What's your great one? I did know that cars were bigger than fences. Thank you for sharing that, Leota. What about, other opposites? Loud, quiet, tall, short. Hot and cold. Ooh, that's a good one. Hot, like summer now, right? And brr, cold. And winter, yeah. All right. So opposites are pretty common, right? Yeah. We have them every day. Lots of times every day. Yeah. Isn't that pretty cool? Sweet and sour, that's another great one. That's a hard one to act out, though, isn't it? Yeah, that's okay. But that's a good one. Sparkly and not sparkly, that's a good one, too. All right. Say that again. Thirsty and hungry, maybe hungry and full. Yeah. Okay. So, over the next week, let's try and think about how many opposites exist in our everyday. And on that note, we will head downstairs. Thank you.
As you go on your way, may you be filled with gladness. Go in joy, go in joy. May fortune bless your day with peace and loving kindness. Go in love, go in love. As you go on,
liberal religion is a vital part of our history of faith. As a covenanted community, people who freely choose to be here Our voluntary giving is symbolic of that freedom of choice. Each week at Bucksmont, we share our offering with a different cause or organization in the community. For the month of August, we are sharing with the Jack and Rosemary Schieber Memorial Immigrant Scholarship Fund. The Immigrant Scholarship Fund has traditionally been our split plate for the month of September. We are hoping that by changing to August, we will be able to award the scholarship at the beginning of the fall school session. We begin the split plate by awarding one scholarship. Last year, we were able to offer two scholarships. Our goal is to offer more scholarships to deserving immigrant students as we honor Jack and Rosemary. Your generous donations will help make this Peace and Justice Committee dream come true. We ask that you participate in our morning offering in one of these ways. You can write out a check to Bucksmont and mail it into the fellowship. You may donate online now or at the end of our worship service. Or you may place your donation into one of the baskets as they are passed. You will now receive the morning offering.
This morning's reading is from Home is Not a Place by Mimi Mawia. Sometimes home is good food and good company, which could be a cob of maize or the company of ourselves. Home is where we are able to thrive without the pressure to. In fact, home is a gentle voice saying, take your time, no pressure. Home is where we dare to be ourselves, where we dare to be unashamed about the things we feel. Home is wherever you find new energy to keep going, even though you know it won't always be easy. Home is where you dare admit you are tired and could really just do with a rest. Home is the families we are born into and those we create for ourselves, be they by heart or by blood. Home is the names we are called by that give us the comfort of familiarity. Home is wherever we need not put up any facades, where we can just be. Sometimes home is solitude. Sometimes it is the need for the noises that can drown out our thoughts. Strange noises, familiar noises. Sometimes home is a song, and sometimes it is the memory triggered by a song. Sometimes home is just knowing we are loved, and we have loved. And other times it is fighting for love. Sometimes home is finding purpose. But more times than not, it is being purpose. Home is knowing greatness dwells within us, and therefore we dwell in greatness, and that greatness is our home. Sometimes when someone has an idea for a homily, it invites them to slow down, to lean into the research and the discoveries that ask them to grow and broaden their understanding, stimulating their intellect. This idea often leads someone to listen to the questions and wisdom of those who lived long ago and feel how their relevance permeates the present, to rest in the connection and the interconnectedness that transcends time. The writings of Heraclitus, a 6th, 5th BCE Greek philosopher known for his central ideas of the unity of opposites, such as hot and cold, hungry and satiated, the concept of change, and how the world is constantly in flux, are testament to such reflection. Not only do they sound like modern day memes with phrases like, everything flows, there is nothing permanent except change, and nothing is, everything is becoming, really did not go over well with other philosophers of his time. They felt like he had no logic, no connection to logos, and he was like, I don't care. He was irreverent in his time. But they also hold paradoxes and complexities of our current era. A few writings come to mind. One is, the road up and the road down are the same. As Angie Hobbs, professor of the public understanding of philosophy at the University of Sheffield, explains, this writing illuminates Heraclitus's thinking that one's geographical location shapes one's understanding of events and ultimately the cosmos. As she points out, if you are at the bottom of the road, it's going to be the road up. If you're starting at the top, it's going to be the road down. But it is, of course, always the same road. Another is his most famous saying, as they step into the same rivers, other and still other waters flow upon them. Or its paraphrase, no man steps in the same river twice. Hobbes suggests that this reflects the idea that because the waters are always flowing in the river, because the banks of the river are always eroding, the stones are always being smoothed away and moved around, there's going to be slight changes in the course of the river over time. In other words, the river does not remain the same. However, she notes, Heraclitus thinks that flux, that movement, creates identity, so that if the river wasn't moving, wasn't flowing, it wouldn't be a river. It would be a sort of immensely long lake with access to the sea at one end, I suppose, is what she said. Charles H. Kahn, who was a professor of philosophy at the University of Pennsylvania, similarly expresses this idea in his book, The Art and Thought of Heraclitus. He writes, "What is emphasized is that the structure and hence the identity of a given river remains fixed, despite or even because its substance is constantly changing. And if the parallel mentioned above is pressed, something similar is indicated about the structure and identity of the individual human beings. And so as we journey through our lives, if we are fortunate enough to move through the stages of growth and aging with not too many discomforts, we change and our identities remain." This observation beckons us to deeply explore and self-reflect on the experience of returning home, as I'm doing today. Whether that be to one's family of origin, one's chosen family, or one's religious or spiritual community. How might one be encouraged to acknowledge the changes that have occurred or are occurring while still remaining open-hearted, with love at the center, guiding one's moment to moment? Can you return and be with people where they are? If, as Mimi Mawia writes, home is a memory of the goodness of life, it is the reminder of a life well lived and the moments that have gone into living that life. Home is where we can dare to be ourselves without fear of being judged or ridiculed. Home is the friendship we forge, the people we count on, the people we know love us as we are, the people who keep loving us and accepting us even when we mess up. Home is knowing we can always do more, be more, but still be enough as we are. All things that I have experienced being a part of this community. Then I ask myself, am I willing to engage in those spiritual practices that keep my heart open and enable love and grace to move through me? Am I willing to acknowledge and embrace that such a feeling, experience, sensation of home asks that I participate in the creation of it? That such a sense of home travels with us because it resides within us. That this home, a source of comfort and care, beckons me to deepen and dwell within the love that burns like a flame within me, within all. It laments when I drown out or silence the voice still and small deep inside all. It wilts when I do not honor the changes that others have gone through. So can I allow my awareness to help me love and care more deeply for others who are struggling and hurting? When that voice rises up in my head, that unkind voice, can I go, thank you so much for sharing, I'm just gonna love? Or when a voice that seems connected to deep-seated systemic stuff comes up, can I go, nope, not very spiritual, no. Am I ready to witness to and honor love's call that all human beings are my siblings and set down this self-righteous feeling that might arise or judgments that might arise every now and then? Am I willing to be a vessel for love, to embody love to protect others? And these questions can be challenging to think about, to answer, but they can become a daily practice, even if I might stumble every now and then, because you can always go back to practice. I can be mindful of my thoughts and words. I can practice being filled with and sharing loving kindness. And might I always know these words by Heraclitus to be true, that the sun is new every day. So I have a little something I want to share that means a lot to me. And some of you may know it. It was part of the acceptance speech that Mr. Rogers gave in 1977 when he received his Lifetime Achievement Award. Has anybody seen that video? One of the beautiful things about it is there's not a dry eye in the house, and everybody is a grown-up. Everybody. But Mr. Rogers just brings out that love, that sense of home. We all felt like we were at home, even though I never understood why he took his shoes off or changed his sweater. I still don't know. But he started off by saying this, and I'm going to modify it slightly while we're gathered here together in this space. Oh, it's a beautiful day in this neighborhood. So many people have helped me to come to this time and place. Some of you are here, some are far away, and some are even in heaven. All of us have special ones who have loved us into being. Would you just take a moment along with me, take 10 seconds to think of the people who have helped you become who you are, to maybe even think of people within this space who have cared about you and wanted the best for you in life and have loved you. 10 seconds of silence. I'll watch the time. Whomever you've been thinking about, how pleased they must be to know the difference you feel they have made. You know, they're the kind of people television does well to offer our world. May it be so.
Please rise in body or spirit and join me in singing hymn number 6, Just As Long As I Have Breath.
Now enter into awareness within ourselves and connection beyond boundaries, connection to one another, to that interdependent web of life of which we are but one small thread. As we breathe in, we are connected. As we breathe out, we are connected. And I invite you in this moment of deep breathing to imagine that every time you exhale, love gets sent to those around you. And that every time you breathe in, you receive the love of those who are near you in this moment. As we breathe in, we are connected. As we breathe out, we are connected. May our minds create a vision of a world radical enough to be called holy. May our actions contain the promise of hope and commitment to justice. May our hearts remember that love is a power that resists all forms of fear. By our thoughts, by our actions, by our hearts, and by our very breath, may it be so.
As part of our caring outreach to one another, we set aside a few moments to note both sorrows and joys in our lives. In these moments of peace and reflection, we turn our attention to one another. We hold each and all in our compassionate thoughts and the prayers of our hearts. This morning, we are adding stones to water. The bowl includes some of the water we gathered as a community back in September, so it contains the love of our congregation surrounding each joy or sorrow. As we add the stones to the bowl of water, we add a piece of our own stories to the collective waters of this community, a place that also holds the memories of those who have gone before and anticipates those who have yet to arrive. To share the joy or sorrow you would like held by our caring community, text the number that is now on screen. Please include your name along with your sharing. It is the same number no matter how you join us today, and you can add it to your contacts for future weeks. I'll read them aloud, and Shay will add a stone on your behalf. What is shared today will go out in our weekly caring notes for those who cannot be with us this morning. Please remember to include your first and last name with what you share. And now we'll add a final stone for all the joys and sorrows that remain unspoken and deep within our hearts. With stones gathered and remembrances shared, we honor our joys and our sorrows. Those shared this morning and the many more that exist beyond words. Through our time together, our relationships are deepened and our community made whole.
Please rise in body or spirit and join me in singing our closing hymn, "There's a River Flowing in My Soul."
River.
Our chalice extinguishing words this morning are from Amy Zucker Morgenstern. May all our hours together be blessed as this one has been, by open-hearted sharing, learning from one another, and making beautiful harmonies together. And may we greet everyone we encounter with the same acceptance and grateful kinship until we meet again. Blessed be.
As our community departs from this service, may we remember all who came before. May we imagine all who will come after. May we honor all who are present with us, here and now. In our time together, we create this community, one of promise, one of commitment, one of love. In our time together, may each of us become a sanctuary for all we meet on this journey. May we go together now and return again.